All right. It is Saturday morning. It is one time once again for the Oh Yeah Show. I am L.J. James. I'm here with distinguished Preach from Sucker Free MC. I got Lorenzo over here. Oh yeah. Our sponsor from Home Base Technologies and the one and only Cowboy Joe. Oh yeah. What's going on, my friends?
All right.
Another great, wonderful week to be alive. It's still wintertime. We're hoping the weather will warm
snowstorm
up soon.
On Monday, snowstorm Sunday,
Sunday
Monday.
Night, Monday night. Oh yeah. My God. Once again, this has gotten to be like upstate Rochester. This is why I left upstate Rochester, all right? Came down.
That's so you're the reason this came down here?
Yeah, well, I left like 14 years ago.
So it's all running a little late. It
found me. It found me. So, you know, I tell you, man, I love Long Island. I love Long Island. It's a beautiful place. But you know what? I keep getting options all the time, man, to go all the places. And I tell you, man, it's getting harder and harder all the time. If it wasn't for, like I said, you know, my friends and all that are down here, my family's all gone. Everybody's gone. Everybody I came down here to see back in 99 have all moved off Long Island. I mean, I'm not even kidding. They're all gone. My cousins, my friends.
Is this a good thing? Yeah,
I mean, I'm trying not to take it personal. You know, but a little rough sometimes, you know. It's like, all right, I mean, I'll go see so-and-so. But no, he lives in California now, and he's like, "Oh, come on by." Everybody's like, everybody wants me to move over to where they're at. So I don't know. Beautiful.
That's all because they want to move again.
Yeah, I think they just missed me. I'm a very fun guy, man. I mean, especially when I'm drinking alcohol. So, but I tell you, I want to start talking about some of the things in the news. And listen, once again, I just want to shout out there. Listen, we need sponsors. I mean, to keep this thing going. Don't be afraid. I know wintertime's tough for everybody. No, I didn't shave today. I got this little beard growing on, but I'm going to shave it tonight. But it looks pretty good, I think. It looks distinguished looking. But listen, we do need sponsors. We always need guests for the panel. You know, always come on. But, you know, we're going to recycle the panel all the time. I mean, but we want new people, too. If you'd like to be on, contact us. You go on Facebook, look up L.J. James, you know, look me up, check it out, or just type in Oh yeah, and see what pops up there. But I tell you, I'm going through the news, man. I'm going through the news like I always do. Always going through the news, and I try to find topics that I think that are worthy of mentioning on the Oh yeah show. And
like alligators who climb trees.
Alligators that climb trees. So listen, the idea is it's supposed to be a topic that makes you go, "Oh yeah!" Oh, you know, it's like, "Wow, what the hell's going on here?" You know. But this here is a guy, this is upstate New York. Now, as a farmer, this farmer now, he's noticing his cows are acting a little weird, all right? They're not producing milk. They're acting funny. They're giving him an attitude, you know? He's like, what the hell?
It sounds like he found out they were actually women.
Well, yeah. They were women.
That was the locals.
They are women.
That was part of the problem.
Sorry.
But you're on the right track. So he decides.
Which is kind
of scary. So he decides to set up cameras. Let's set up cameras. And all of a sudden he's watching the film. And he has, let's get it on. And he finds two local boys, and they're there having sex with the cows. They're coming in and they're having sex with the cows. And I think one guy like brought a camera with them and all that.
Okay.
But these guys, they were released. They were charged with animal cruelty and abuse, and then released. I mean, like this isn't a big crime.
You know, I'll tell you what.
The scary part is that it's, you know, anybody is looking at this at all to begin with, that's just wrong. And the farmer's like, huh?
The real criminals weren't even involved in this whole article or the conversation. I'm going to tell you who the real criminals were. The ugly ass women up there that the guys felt that their only option was to have sex with cows. How bad do the women have to look that cows are the option?
I lived upstate, and while some of the women aren't that good looking, the Bigfoot looking ones, I mean, there are some beautiful women up there. They've got that country girl. Listen, I tell you, me, I got a soft spot. You ever see that country girl look, you know? They got the horse riding pants
Marianne.
On that are real tight. Yeah, Marianne, like that. You know, the pigtails, they got the horse riding pants on, they got the tight little tied off shirt. That's, listen, man, that is the Marianne. I mean, I tell you, I like that.
But I mean, they're not even providing the inspiration for the guys to jerk off to. The girls have repulsed the guys so much that they've resorted to having
sex with
cows.
Do we blame it completely on the women?
Yes, it's always a woman's fault. It's always a woman's fault.
Maybe these were just extremely good-looking cows. I mean, we don't know. I mean,
you know what, to be fair? I didn't think about that.
These cows could have been something special.
I'm sure they didn't complain.
I didn't think about that.
That's why the guy got caught. They're sitting there until they got caught because the cows are acting all bitchy and all that. Nobody brought me dinner. I didn't get my flowers. I mean, even
they
cows,
didn't kiss
man.
Me first.
Yeah.
Typical women, goddammit. Even cows. Blew the whole cows act like women.
This is a very sad story. I think...
You're going to go from cow sex to sad story?
I was transition.
It's up and down. It is. How's it animal cruelty? I don't know. Maybe they didn't have an orgasm.
The guys had a good time.
You got him. If you're going to
know if the cow complained.
Well, they weren't happy though.
They weren't producing.
I think the pig squealed on him.
The pig squealed.
It was New York. Upstate New York.
Really? I thought it was
New York.
Third country world.
I think.
I thought it was Jersey.
I want to say, listen, something very sad, very serious. It's very sad. A classical, one of our very, what is he waving at me? You leaving? What the heck's going on? Go to the show here.
He said, get out of here.
I think he knows that cow.
Can you?
You know the cow.
don't talk about my girlfriend.
Don't
like
talk
that.
About her.
All right, I just got one word to say, man. Can you dig it?
You know he died this week.
I thought I'd bring it up.
Oh, he broke it. Breaking my heart, man. Breaking my heart.
One of the greatest movies of all time.
Yes.
I mean, everybody's seen The Warriors, right? Right, Joe, you've seen The Warriors?
Yeah.
I mean, I know one person here hasn't seen it.
You haven't seen The Warriors?
You haven't seen The Warriors.
I don't know who you're talking about.
Who the fuck is this guy?
Listen, I'm a big movie buff, too.
You haven't seen The Warriors.
Talking the other day.
I'm losing my voice.
That's it.
Cut the commercial. I know. Let's cut the commercial. We're about to fuck him up.
One of the greatest movies. Gotta be one of the greatest movies of all time. But we're gonna rectify this. Listen, I actually have the movie.
So we're gonna watch it.
Before next time comes around.
Anybody who's seen the movie, sorry.
Was it when B a D list?
Knows who Cyrus was. I forget his real name. I mean,
Roger Hill.
Okay. But I mean, listen. At the beginning of the movie, I mean, when he's trying to reunite all the gangs in New York City, I mean, the lines and the speech he makes and all that was just, you know, can you dig it? I mean,
Don't look at me like that.
It is one of the best lines of all time.
Who hasn't said that you had a party and drank, can you? I mean, during the 70s, that was it.
The 70s, see, they
said it. It doesn't matter. The movie transcends. It's like, look, there's certain movies that go up there. There's like The Color Purple, there's Schindler's List, there's The Warriors.
The Warriors and Schindler's List?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
Okay, listen. I put it first. When I see this, I'm going to rate it at that.
There's Jesus of Nazareth. The Warriors. It works that way. How do you not see that?
All right. I'll have to see it.
Yeah, I'll see it.
Oh, God.
I'll watch the movie.
But he died. He was 65 years old.
Young guy.
Like I said, he's very young nowadays. Yeah. But nowadays, if people living to 90, I hope I make it to 65. I don't,
Stop smoking.
I'm 43. Listen. I've said these years... The years in your life, not the life in your years. I mean, actually, I haven't smoked crack. I mean, listen, I don't smoke crack.
Just to clear that up.
I do a lot of stuff, but I don't smoke crack.
Yeah, okay. You went to Houston.
Me and Whitney Houston. I'm more of a take a pill and relax type of guy, you know? I live a nice, easy life, try not to be stressed. Stress-free. Stress-free is the way to be. But what are we doing over here? Is he dressing him or?
No, he's the guy who didn't see The Warriors. About to choke him out.
I love it. All right, well, listen, another thing's in the news I want to talk about.
Michael Keaton signed on. Michael Keaton signed on. He hasn't done a lot, man.
He's been in a few. Every once in a while. He's in RoboCop.
He is in RoboCop.
Yeah. I didn't see
the What, the new version?
The new one, yeah.
I just watched the old version. That's just wrong.
Yeah, it is wrong. The original one was very good.
Well,
I heard it was good.
I heard it was good, but
Peter Weller was good at parts like that.
He was, but this is a problem that I have with the new
RoboCop
one.
RoboCop and Buckaroo Banzai, the only things people remember.
Buckaroo Banzai. I remember Buckaroo Banzai. I remember that. See, that's a
straight F.
It wasn't F, but I still watched it.
that's like that movie about those time pirates. Remember those bandits?
Right, time bandits.
Those were horrible. Those were horrible. You saw time bandits,
I saw time bandits.
It's terrible.
Like Ice Pirates.
I've lost control.
One of those things produced by Mike Nesmith, which would explain a lot.
Oh, sure. Time Bandits was that was.
If you're not throwing midgets, they shouldn't be on the screen. What were you saying, dude?
I'm just waiting. I'm wondering when
this guy's on
the Siskel and Ebert.
We should do a movie review.
We should actually, man.
Two thumbs up.
We got the new setting over there. I think we can do a nice movie.
We can do it over there.
Right? Right, yeah, you know, we can show clips from the movies, get some free movies. I like popcorn.
Yeah, but do we really have to show clips from Time Bandits, please?
No, we would do new movies. Okay. We do new movies.
So RoboCop, you're saying.
RoboCop would be good, but like I said, Michael Keaton, I mean, listen, I like Michael Keaton. I thought he was a great actor.
I don't know how well a second installment of Beetlejuice is going to do.
I think it'll do just great.
I think so, too.
I mean, listen, there are certain things in this world that I've missed and I thought that were lacking from the world.
Beetlejuice 2 is one of those things, man.
Seriously, stop smoking crack.
Listen, man, I'm serious.
Beetlejuice
speaking of crack, I don't know if we touched on this last week and all that. I almost think we did, but I'm just going to talk about it anyway. This guy keeps fondling him, man. What's going on over here?
Do we all get the fondling?
Yeah. I got to reach around here. Clip it right to his beard. Did we talk about Girl Scouts? The Girl Scouts are, there's this girl, she's 13 years old. I guess a couple of them have done it. And
good for them.
They're selling, well, not done that. But the Girl Scouts.
I know this.
They're selling cookies outside of the marijuana clinics in California and in different areas. And now they're trying to say that it's inappropriate for young girls that are, listen, you know, that 12, 13 and on to be there. But listen, in defense, one 13-year-old girl sold 117 boxes in 1 week.
And that was just to one guy.
just outside of it. I mean, now listen. I mean, if she was standing outside of a liquor store, would that be inappropriate to sell cookies outside of an alcohol?
But now, beverage shelter. You know, what do the Thin Mints really go with? Come on. I mean, what are you doing?
You go where the money's going.
Listen. Listen. This girl needs to be applauded for her tactical and strategic thinking. That's what she needs to be applauded. Listen. I come from that background. She identified her consumer. She identified a need for her consumer, a necessity, and she was there, and she made some money.
And it was legal.
She should win the salesperson of the year.
I think so, too.
If she stays there, if they let her stay there, she probably will.
It's absolutely brilliant.
I think it's a brilliant idea. I don't know why it's an issue,
future,
man.
Future
I think,
marketing consultant.
I think if someone's upset, they didn't think of it first. You know?
Right. That's what it comes down
and
to.
And I think what's going to happen is I think they're afraid that every single Girl Scout out there is going to start going, hey, listen, man, I want to.
If they're making money. One of the leaders coming out.
I think everybody wins.
If they're making money, the Girl Scouts, they're kicking the money up like they're supposed to. So who cares? They're not there to buy weed. It's not like they're bartering Samoans for, you know, a nickel bag. So what?
That would work with me, though. But I mean,
I don't give up Samoans. You
know, I still think they don't want you to join the Girl Scouts after that last incident.
Well, I'll just collate the brownies.
What was that one?
Eating the brownies.
I missed that incident. Okay.
That's an old joke. I ate a brownie. Listen, you know, while we're here and all that, I'm going to do my ad. We're doing it in reverse today. We're going to go to the commercial. All right. We go to Lorenzo at Home Base Technologies. Yo, over here. Listen,
I do.
Computer guy extraordinaire. We got his picture up there on the TV.
I don't look,
but that's no, that's right. I like that picture. I found it online,
but I don't
man.
Have gray hair.
You don't have gray hair, but you're, it's a doctor. It's funny. It's a comedy.
It's gray
it in here. It makes people remember, all right? So, now listen, if people have problems, I'm going to talk to you now. If people have problems with the computer, they come talk to you.
Yep.
In the computer industry since 1993... You have expertise with legal and financial community, all right? Is that legal like the criminal? Or?
Well, all sorts of lawyers.
All sorts of
real
lawyers?
Estate lawyers, yeah, criminal lawyers, personal injury attorneys, manufacturing, all sorts of...
you provide also on-site remote email and phone support.
That's right.
So they can call you anyway. I mean, actually, I mean, you were telling me you were at Disney World with your family.
That's right.
And you actually got a call from a client and you helped them, and you
sure.
worked with them right through there.
Yeah.
With your laptop and everything
he
like that.
Hijacked
and
the Disney computer.
Yeah, yeah.
And he was cool.
So I'm on Dumbo
if
right
I,
now.
If I watch a lot of porn on my computer and I get viruses, I can bring it to you.
Sure.
I am I am back to the porn, baby. Back to the porn. Got Lorenzo here.
Right. You get all kinds when you don't on computers, man.
Remote access.
Yeah, awesome.
Now, remote access to your desktop from home or on the road. So if you're driving to work and all that, you can just
I don't
still,
recommend that.
You can still look at your house and watch, you know.
Yeah, I don't recommend
well, you want to watch it. You want to watch what's going on in your house, man. You know,
at the airport.
Make sure nobody's banging your cows. You know, I'm telling you. You know, it's a serious thing. It's gonna be a new business partner for you. You know, well, you guys.
Dairy farmers upstate. They need,
they need somebody, man. I mean, you might have to travel a little bit, but it might be worth the money. If you see any good-looking cows, let us know. servicing the greater New York City, Long Island, and Westchester areas. Maybe coming to your upstate New York, who knows. Very professional, courteous, and knowledgeable, honest and fair.
Right.
They'll give you the solution that's best for you. If you'd like a network evaluation to see Lorenzo here and make sure your current equipment is doing the job you need it to do, just they can give you a call, right? Or what's your number?
631-338-0281.
All right. They also do residential PCs, home networks, both wired and wireless. All right. They will explain all the options that are available to you. And you check them also. Check them out. Once you got the website, it's homebasetechnologies.com. That's homebasetechnologies.com. And it's very good. All right, man. We are back. All right.
I got one.
You got a story?
Yeah. It's somewhat of a serious one. You know, like you said, you know, a lot of people, because they know we're bikers, want us to touch on at least one biker topic a week. So I got
yes.
one for
That's
you.
That's a good idea.
That's a good idea, right?
Good idea bikers have.
You know, you guys remember those idiots on the West Side Highway?
We do.
Last
I know.
The ones that everybody kept calling bikers, but were actually just
yes.
jackasses.
Yes. Yeah. So,
the
so the
really hurt everybody.
So the jackasses
it
on...
You killed everybody else. It
so
really
the,
did. It,
so the jackasses on two wheels. That's what we'll refer to them as. Well... They were thinking that the district attorney was going to take the charges down because the person that they attacked has recovered so well. However, the district attorney has made it quite clear that they are not going to take down the charges.
Can they bring a few more up?
Well, they said that they would still face gang assault charges, which of course is a few counts as a few different types of felonies in New York State, and it would appear that. You know, New York is really going to make an example, or try to make an example out of these guys. And the scary thing is, for everybody else, they're going to make an example out of them, and we're all going to feel the
same. I was
going to
say, everybody else is going to get lumped into this.
Yeah,
you know,
absolutely.
That was the biggest problem.
You know,
that's what kept annoying me when they kept calling them bikers on the news and everything.
Well, they were calling them motorcycle clubs, motorcycle gangs. I mean, the names that they kept throwing out there, where these guys were just a rogue group of individuals, pretty much. I think I saw some patches, you know, whatnot, but I don't think the guys were there representing their clubs. I think they were just there, because the idea of the whole thing was it's like a chaos type thing event where they try to close down whatever it was, Times Square or I forget the exact area.
Well, they started in Times Square. And
they
start
from
crazy.
Well, I heard they start from